side, isn't he?
Yep.
God damn it. Alright, Bing.
Hello, gentlemen.
Evening, officer.
Hi.
Is there any good reason why you're driving down Hilliard Road at 10 miles an hour?
Good?
No, not really.
No, not really.
Why do you have two phones?
I'm getting pokey stops for both of us.
And I'm just driving, so I'm not distracted.
You're using two phones for pokey stops, so the driver is not distracted.
Well, yeah. And yes, on top of it, he's also out of pokeballs.
Yeah.
Okay. Number one, aren't you boys a little old to be playing Pokemon Go?
Well, it didn't really have an age range when it came out.
Yeah,
did
it's
it?
Kind of one of those
things. Nothing really said. I mean, it's an unspoken rule if you played it when you were a kid.
You guys look like you're 40.
Hey.
I'm at most in my early 30s, sir.
All right. Please speed up on Hilliard Road. The speed limit is 35 miles an hour. Please keep up with traffic.
Well, there's no one on the road right now. It's like 2 a.m.
It doesn't matter.
Dude, don't argue, man.
Okay.
And just so you know, I don't do this Pokemon Go thing, but there's a Snorlax behind the school over there. Go get it.
Are you serious?
Really?
Have a good day.
What? Did he just... Fuck!
Let's go! And that's why Ben Roethlisberger is not allowed in Seattle.
Well, it makes perfect sense. I mean, Jesus Christ, you kill that many people. Fuck. You know?
I thought it was because he touched too many little boys.
Something like that.
Well, shit. I mean, Pittsburgh.
They suck.
Yeah.
There goes that fan base.
Go Browns.
All right. Aren't they terrible?
Does not matter. Die hard.
There you go.
Do you like Browns Team 1 more than Browns Team 2?
If they are the Cleveland Browns, I love them.
I believe they're also known as the Baltimore Ravens.
The Ravens suck donkey ball.
The Electric Ravens.
I was going to say, are they also characters from Mortal Kombat?
Yes.
Sweet.
Hell yes.
That'd probably be the best football team ever.
I would agree, actually.
That would be pretty sweet.
The Cleveland Sub-Zeros.
No.
Scorpions.
Yeah.
What's wrong with
Get over here! He just, like, throws a harpoon in the ball.
See? Boom, done. Game over.
What's Interception.
What's...
Get over here!
Guys.
Hey!
Hi, welcome to Geek Eclectic. I'm Nick.
And this is Nick as well.
Easy to pick.
This isn't Joe.
And not, Joe's not here.
Joe's not here.
Nope.
A.K.A. Hefty Bison.
Hi.
And the Vickle.
The Vickle.
Let's see, we've got a few topics. Sorry it's been so long. I was basically dying.
Are you okay now, though?
Mostly.
Good.
Yeah.
We almost did a cast while I was laying carpet in my basement.
Almost. It did not come out well.
No. That was pretty bad.
The constant did not go over well.
Ripping of plastic and... Yeah, it was bad.
And then the constant repositioning.
We tried to do it through, what was it? Google Hangouts.
Yes.
And I was wearing a mic, and we were echoing off each other.
It was
really
quite
bad.
Entertaining. Yeah. But yeah, let's see. Today we're going to be talking about Pokemon Go. What else? Oh, we're also going to touch on everyone's favorite game.
Pokemon Joe. Hey.
I like it.
Pokemon Go is now a fucking joke, because there's no way to track your Pokemon. With the game, or through apps, or through websites. Because
that's fun.
Yeah, they suck.
Let's see. Which one do you want to start with first? The Pokemon or Division?
Joe's
one of our favorite podcasts being...
Rogue Agent Radio?
There it is gone.
Or
at least seems to be gone.
They're on a longer hiatus.
Huh. And we're back after finding Joe's dog.
Everyone, Lexi is safe and sound now in the house.
Yes.
There we go.
We are doing a cast from outside. It is not ungodly hot.
It's nice.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, as nice as it can be with warmth, but still.
There's no hobbits
throwing
rings in the backyard.
Not yours. Not currently. No. But let's see. As we said before, Rogue Agent Radio is gone, which kind of bums me.
We still have Bombshell Jackets.
We do still have Bombshell Jackets. And also, they've got a new one that's him and one of the Bombshell girls.
Dave and Tinks?
Tinks, I think it is.
Let's do Pokemon, because I cannot keep my eyes off this screen just in case anything pops up.
Nothing ever pops up out here.
I play Pokemon Go every day.
So, my wife, we were driving around last night looking for Pokemon, thinking that PokeVision's going to be up at any given time after the Pokemon update.
Mm-hmm.
And my wife sends me this video that I had no idea what it was, but at the time, my phone was connected to the charger, which is connected to the stereo.
Through the USB port.
And the I Play Pokemon Go song is playing. If you haven't,
look it up. Play a clip.
Should I play a clip?
You should play up to 12 seconds.
I play up to 12 seconds without getting any kind of...
without any kind of fine or copyright infringement of any kind. But I think us doing it right there was fine. This is going to blow that fucking thing out. Or it's muted, one of the two.
That's muted. So there is our hopefully less than 12 seconds. So that just starts pumping through the stereo,
which is not unsoft.
No,
not
it was ungodly loud, and we all just started crying because it was.
I almost had to pull the car over. It was beautiful.
Yes,
I had tears in my eyes.
Oh.
Hey, Pepsi Company, if you're listening, I love Mountain Dew. Feel free to send me some.
So we just beg for an endorsement.
There we go.
Soft beg for an endorsement.
Yeah, soft.
In the first 10 minutes of the show. There we go. I like
it. Well, I just opened up a fresh one.
That's true. What are we drinking tonight, people?
Mountain Dew.
Ecto Cooler.
Ecto Cooler right here.
Actually, I finished mine already, I think.
I'm saving mine.
Nope, did I? Nope.
I'm saving Ecto Cooler.
Still can't find it in a can.
Nope.
Might go and start Poke hunting on Wednesday. I'm going to hunt for Ecto Cooler.
I like that.
There you go.
I myself... found one place that has it, and I don't want to say it because in case I can find more, but literally I bought 8 cases.
I was wondering why every time I saw you gave me an Ecto Cooler.
And you keep bringing them over for my daughter.
Yeah,
which is awesome for me.
Yeah, it's the coolest.
It is. All right, so the obsession is extremely real.
Yeah,
it is super fun, which it was cool before when you were just kind of like walking around and stuff, but then the three paw glitch where you couldn't where you couldn't see where anything was, and then the awesome update where they're like, we fixed the three paw glitch, which turned out they didn't. They just removed all the paws.
Yeah,
so now you see nothing.
Now you just see what's in your area,
what's in 700 meters of you.
Well, that's fun.
Yeah, just 700 meters in any direction.
But the three step thing was 300 meters.
Maybe then it's 300 meters. I don't know. I heard it was 700 meters.
I don't like it.
Could be 300. I don't know.
I like thinking each paw is 100 meters.
There you go.
That's kind of what we went by.
Yeah.
Still a lot of meters.
It's copious amounts of meters.
300 meters in any direction? You have no idea?
Pretty much no. Yeah. And zeroing in was a total bitch, which we've tried.
Oh. So, and then with that, tried. One of the greatest things ever invented came out. Which was PokeVision, which still wasn't 100%.
Oh, God, no.
Never 100%.
But still, way still, it was great. Not.
We all got a Snorlax from it.
Yes, we did.
Which, unfortunately, me and Nick also got fucked.
I did not.
Joe did not.
Joe,
all three
what's
of us,
yours?
Well, hold on. Let me pull it up.
All three of us caught the same Snorlax at the same time.
And what were your guys' levels?
42,
which is the minimum for a Snorlax.
Mine, the answer to life, the universe, and everything. I'm not upgrading mine at all.
No. Mine is 1,859.
You bitch.
Yep. That's how that goes.
You bitch, straight off the bat, actually.
Yeah. So, as of the update...
just plain.
Well, thank you. Appreciate
that. I'm looking at my screen right now, too. something might pop up, you know?
It's not. It's fine.
Yeah, as of the update, all the Pokemon supposed cheat apps and websites do not work. You can use the crowdsource stuff, which usually turns out to be bullshit.
And crap.
And crap.
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's never there. But yeah, none of them work. I don't know if they were shut down. No one is talking. If it was cease and desist, change in code. But the guy who runs Pokevision said, you know, if, you know, Niantic and Nintendo want me to stop, I'll stop.
Which means they got a cease and desist.
So, you know, he said this a while ago. So, and now they're gone, but all of them, none of them work. Like, I went through 10 apps today.
So it's got to be a source code change.
I think it's a source code change, because there was something I read on Reddit that they said that they were changing it to the point where the map was refreshing so many times per every 5 seconds.
Yeah.
So it was showing your location exactly. So it was, I guess people are having trouble keeping up with it. But at the same time, I haven't had a crash since the update.
I have.
Ooh. Have you had as many?
No, not as many. But I still have it freeze, and it has crashed and not rebooted several times.
No.
Not as many as it was before the update, but it has still happened.
Yeah. Still not perfect. So yeah, Pokevision's gone, which everyone's kind of pissed about, and like threatening to not play anymore.
How the fuck do you have that?
What?
I'm at the moment looking up his thing on the little, this thing.
Sulph Road. Which is a very, and very awesome web app.
Is it 198 HP?
I don't know, I'm healing.
Is not possible. I'm at the bottom of the fucking scale.
Wait, what's not possible?
You gotta move the thing back. Yeah, you have his, here, let me see here.
Between 18 and fucking
1859.
It's between 17.
1859.
HP is 198.
Yeah, you had the gauge over too far. 1859. Which, that's not possible.
That's what I'm fucking talking about. I've fiddled a bit. But yeah, alright, so. Pokemon Vision was a godsend and is currently not up.
That website was awesome.
And the fucking. You know, I wouldn't be annoyed or even slightly pissed if it was. Okay, here, overall. We've fixed the radar system. Not only will you have the steps, you'll have also a fucking direction of where it's at.
Yes.
That would be fantastic.
I wouldn't give a shit about Pokemon Vision being gone.
Well, you wouldn't need it. You really wouldn't need it unless you're really hunting for something specific.
Exactly, which I do occasionally still.
I know you do.
So it's saying your Sulph Road says your HP kind of sucks, but everything else is pretty tits.
Tits McGits?
Tis we gets.
All right.
Hits hard, but your HP sucks.
Yeah, I believe that.
Yeah. Sucks because Snorlax is one of those ones where it's like a one in a million to get.
Yeah. And
we were three in a million.
That's damn right.
Well, yeah.
You know what it was? Pokevision in a million.
Pokevision in a million.
Pokevision in a million.
Thank you, Pokevision.
Yeah. Yes.
Rest in peace, possibly, or we look forward to your return. One of the two.
One of these days, which I keep on
hoping. You keep on going to that fucking site still.
I'm trying another site, but it keeps on taking me back to Manhattan. Another app.
Nice. Alright, overall, what are you guys' levels?
Oh god, Joe, what are you at now?
I know, that's really...
Only 22.
Oh, okay. I'm still beating you. I'm at 23.
I'm at 20, finally.
Nice!
I know! And I accidentally used 2 eggs yesterday. One of them unintentionally.
Oh yeah, that was funny. Oh, servers are temporarily too busy.
That fucking Pokemon Go song is stuck in my head.
Then the whole matter of the day is complete.
Yes, we have completed.
This has been Geek Eclectic. Thank you for watching.
They're not watching.
Yes, it's on YouTube.
No, they're listening.
I put stuff on the video thing.
Oh, you're one of those guys?
Just you random. You kind of have to.
Yeah.
No, just make it blank.
And so one of these days when someone...
How fucking happy I'd be if I could.
When someone puts it on iTunes, like it's...
I will put it...
For most podcasts.
Hey, Nick.
$189? What was it? $189?
I think so, yeah.
$189?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to have a full up and running...
We looked and
saw how much we'd have to overall invest in the whole thing to basically make it so we don't have to use the YouTube anymore.
And just run it on iTunes, so people can download it and listen to it and whatever.
It's not even that much, actually. I found one that's not even that much. Yeah. It's like 10 or 20 bucks.
Unless you find someone who wants to pick us up, because there's other, there's like podcast people, like there's groups, podcast groups that actually, like,
yeah, I don't want a shit ton of people. Yeah, I don't want that. I, you know what I want us to eventually be?
I know you want us to be a fucking like conglomerate
that.
Of
that. I want us to be that. I want it to grow to be that. The whole reason this started was I wanted to become the nexus of media.
You wanted to have a voice.
No, well, yes, they need my voice.
It is a pretty voice.
I know. I still listen to it myself occasionally. But
I just listen to myself over and over.
Oh, yes, the lotion's on the table. But overall, you're at 23, you're at 22, I'm at 20. Mm-hmm. What's your best Pokemon? Who's your favorite Pokemon that you have? You can give me a couple. I don't.
I'd have to say Cum Dumpster is one of my favorite Pokemon I have.
That's what I was hoping you were gonna say. And so, what is your Cum Dumpster?
All right, so I got a Victory Bell. All right, so let's start from the beginning. I get my first Bellsprout. I'm like, why does that look like a fleshlight?
No, it was the one that was above the
Weeping Bell. And I'm like, it looks like a sex doll mouth. Like seriously, I'm like, so I named my Weeping Bell Sex Doll Mouth. So then I evolved it, and then I have a Victory Bell, and I'm like, but it looks like a trash can. So now it's Cum Dumpster. Look, Meg, I found a shirt. This one says Dirty Slut. Ooh, this one says Cum Dumpster.
Like, my Weeping Bell is used sex toy.
I don't have a Weeping Bell.
No, oh, Weeping Bell.
Oh, I do, but it's
and small. Let's see, what is it? And used fleshlight, because I have two of them.
I haven't really renamed any of mine except for that. What's the star?
Star you.
The 8-sided star.
Star you. No, it's star. I thought star you is a small one. Yeah. Star me.
Star you is a small one.
I'm looking.
Yeah.
Either way, I changed.
Oh yeah, then star me. I guess.
I changed it to 5-finger Death Punch.
I like that
because they're awesome.
Just a fan.
So my Vapion is probably my strongest at 1888.
My original Drowsy that I upgraded was originally named Bill Cosby, and I've kept it for the, is it Hypno that it becomes?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's Hypno Bill Cosby. Hypno Bill Cosby. I renamed a Slowpoke Garrison after Garrison Keillor. Because let's be honest, the man is phenomenal, but his voice is not the quickest.
No.
But that's part of its fucking appeal overall, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Well, it's been a quiet week, like a bubble gum, Minnesota, my hometown. That I fucking was like, Slowpoke, Garrett. Yeah, it works. Let's see, I've got a Psyduck that's Arthur Dent at CP42.
What's CP42? Like the lowest level you can get.
I'm keeping it, I don't give a fuck. I got a, what is it? Blue Duck, what's the upgrade of Psyduck?
Oh, Golduck.
Golduck. My Golduck is Darkwing Duck. Let's see, what was the other fucking...
See, I don't know if before you could see the names in the gym before the update.
Yes, you could.
You could see other people's names.
Oh, yeah.
But now you can't.
Correct.
Now you cannot.
Oh, that's bullshit.
And my other favorite thing is that when I got my Snorlax at level 42, I renamed it Nick Frost.
Ooh. I have a Wartortle.
Wartortle.
It's very nice, though.
What about you, Joe? What's your best and what's your favorite?
Well, of course, they got that Snorlax that you guys failed on.
It came up as 42 when I got there.
Yep.
Like 42, and then you got question mark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Question marks was a bit of a bitch. We both just sat there like... You used 3 Ultra Balls on that thing.
I did.
So did I.
And I used 1 Pokeball to catch the fucker. Everyone's like, dude, it's so fucking hard. I'm in the back seat. I'm like, whoop.
Got it.
Caught. Like, all right. Fuck yes.
What is that?
Magmar. Oh, Jolteon.
Jolteon. That is, so far, my favorite.
There we go.
I just like electricity fucking things up.
I like that.
So, you know, when I use him, I picture that one guy in, I think it was Guatemala. Or some area that is not
long
us, was hanging up, working on power lines, and got electrocuted and fell to his death. So every time I use him, I think of him.
Huh. A warm, cozy feeling that he gets every time.
Well, he was a criminal, so
There you go. I like it. That's fine. I'm good with that.
All right. We got good, some decent Pokemon for our levels. I have not yet gotten a level 10 or a 10K egg.
Not one.
Not
I've
one.
Gotten not so many.
One. Hang on. Here's the next fun question. Who's paid for this app so far?
I spent $5 on.
I have Lucky spent eggs. 40.
Jesus Christ. Joe, what level were you when I was level 12 and we came over here and I taught you how to throw a Pokeball?
Three, four.
You just power leveled past me. So
don't
hard.
Judge, yo.
So fucking hard.
Well, I got these stops close by, and I just
I've got Clegg Park.
I have nothing to do all fuck day.
I know.
That's so I use eggs.
I know. It's
and true. The things, and they come, and I fuck them up. That's what I do.
So we'd have stuff to do if the division wasn't so fucked up.
One of the greatest games ever not made correctly.
That's a beautiful segue.
With my favorite failed experiment.
Dark Zone. The dark fucking zone. Dark Zone.
God, it sucks. And they keep on like tailoring shit for the Dark Zone.
I know. I couldn't give less of an ounce of a fuck. I haven't been in the Dark Zone in literally 2 months.
Yeah. And half the shit that you can't, like you can't buy, like you can't get good accessory pieces, like add-ons, mods, without going in the Dark Zone.
I know. Dude, I've been pissed off because I've got that pistol that hits like a son of a bitch that I replaced my double barrel shotgun with.
Nice.
I replaced the double barrel shotgun with the pistol, but I don't have any underbarrel pieces for pistols, period.
The one I have is like a blue.
I would be happy with anything.
See, I find blues and purples. I cannot get a gold modification piece for the life of me.
Nope, not anymore.
No magazines, no nothing.
Hey, how's killing those named enemies doing for you?
Yeah.
All right, so let me tell these watchers and listeners a story about the other day. Mm-hmm. We three are playing Division, and we decide that we are going to do
the some of the weekly ones.
Weekly high value targets. Mm-hmm. I spend 40. I'll get to the 70 in a second. I spend 40, and we go all the way there. The game glitches.
Yep.
We
straight freeze.
Like walking up to them, shooting them in the face. They're not
right,
doing anything.
Right here, I'll take the pictures I have from PlayStation. Because I took some pictures of me just standing next to the guys, just milling around.
There's like five or six?
Five or six fucking heavy
flamethrowers.
Yep.
Yeah, and they're just standing there like, ha ha ha.
They're just walking around like, don't notice that we keep shooting at them.
I'm running nothing pulses. Happens. It's not highlighting a single
he had some of the grenade. Like, yeah. It was like nothing's going on.
Nothing worked.
Nope.
And then as soon as I go, oh, I'm going to log off and see what happens.
Everyone came to life.
I was still in the middle of the group. Us.
Yeah, he was standing right next to them.
I was standing in the circle of people.
I tried to run away, and I could not get away fast enough. And my 40 were gone.
Yeah.
And then we decided to do the 30. Level 30.
Because, obviously, your fucking pieces were taken and not, you know, you can't play the goddamn game again.
Yeah, right. You can't play it again.
You couldn't even we couldn't even access it.
Could we? I don't know.
I think it might have been available, but we just didn't have enough money.
Yeah,
enough shit for it. I don't think it was available. I think it came up as failed. Yeah, it came up as failed. Because someone died during it.
And then we do level 30. And what happened on level 30?
Which was funny because it was in the same spot.
Yep.
Same exact spot.
Yep. Uh-huh.
And we run through. We're actually doing really well until the elite shotgunners come out.
Yeah. Can I take a second? I fucking despise parts of this game.
Yes.
Not dislike. You know what? This game is something I really would love to play. And if it was how it was when we fucking started, I'd be so fucking happy.
Yeah.
But it has turned to dog shit about some of these issues. And we're about to cover one of them in fucking detail.
So, the Elite Shotgunners come out, and I'm trying to think, were all of us dead? No, I was the first to go.
You're the first.
I was the first to go, as one of these Elite Shotgunners is coming up, and I unloaded a, was it, 204...
204 sausage.
204 sausage into his face, wearing fucking... Sentry's call.
Full Sentry's call.
Full Sentry's call. Full Sentry's call. Four. Not the five, but the four.
Four's all you
whatever.
Need.
into his face, and he still kills me in one shot.
Yeah.
And then goes and kills you two kills in one shot
first, and then I'm sitting there unloading my, what was mine?
268.
260, no, my armor.
No, it was
227 sausage. I think it was 7, but I'm not sure. But unloading my 227 sausage into his face on the way over, and just fuck dead. Didn't even break all of his armor.
It's ridiculous. Like, we had the same issue the last time me and you played,
mm-hmm.
where you're sitting there shooting guys with a marksman rifle, and you're, like, hitting for 40,000.
Yeah, when my marksman on its...
like, usually hits for, like, 300 to 4.
Yeah, I mean, literally, I've had this marksman actually hit for over 1 million once. Actually, no, twice. Twice, that was beautiful. You remember that one? We're in the fucking sewer one. I sat there, I was like, dude, 1,000,004! 1,000,004! Holy fucking shit! And you're just, like, giggling as I'm doing it. And it's the same gun.
And these guys are just going, bleh, done. Yeah. Bleh, done. Now, like...
now, it doesn't matter. I've got a better... I've got a better marksman rifle with higher hitting and fucking everything.
But that was just that one round mm-hmm. that we went through. And then the next one was fine.
In case anyone listening gives a shit, I don't use any of that fucking water crap. I don't use any of that shit.
Yeah. It's worthless. Without using all the... whatever.
I was just literally using what I was wearing and that.
Should probably try some of the consumables. Might work a little better.
No.
Well, you guys need to use consumables. That's why
you... No, we've tried. We've actually tried doing consumables. Fuck all. Does nothing.
It really doesn't do anything.
It's worthless.
You cannot... I could be wrong, but I don't believe that there is a substantial difference in our hit numbers when we drink the water.
I didn't notice a substantial difference.
You gotta think, it's 20%. What's 20% of dick? Like, you're not doing dick in the first place, and then there's 20% added onto that.
Circumcision is what it is.
Yeah, exactly. It's like throwing foreskin at him.
Just throwing foreskin at him.
Oh my god, he's hit me in the face with foreskin.
I've died.
It's not even a dick, it's just foreskin.
They keep on changing it to fix the dark zone, which is never going to be fixed, and they should just shut that shit down.
Like, I've heard them talk about, was it flagging for Dark Zone?
Which was kind of...
alright, so I guess in... because I haven't played it, and people make fun of me for it. Grand Theft Auto 5.
I love
that. So, on the online, mm-hmm. you can go in, and you can turn off PvP.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So people can't harm you.
Yep. I mean, the people are run you over with a car.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And kill you, but...
they can't shoot you.
They can't shoot you.
Yeah.
Unless you're in a vehicle. You can't shoot them.
Yeah, that too. But you can't shoot them. Well, there's no vehicles
in this, so we don't have to worry about it.
Exactly.
Which I thought would be cool, but then at this point, they're having so many issues with the PvE enemies anyways.
Oh, yeah.
That they'll just smoke you anyways.
Yep.
Yeah, but, I mean, you're going to die. Every time I go in the Dark Zone, there is a group of cum dumpsters waiting on the other side of the door.
AKA rogue agents.
Yeah, I hate that shit. I don't want to do it. All right. I'm not a PvP guy.
No.
I don't like PvP. So anything where it, like, forces you to play PvP really pisses me off.
Agreed.
And the Division, their big thing was you don't have to play PvP to get the best stuff. That was, like, in the beginning. Like, you don't have to play PvP to get this stuff. To get good weapons, you got to get them in the Dark Zone. To get the, like, cachet drops, you got to get them in the Dark Zone. Get all this shit, you got to get it in the Dark Zone.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the fucking, all the, because, like, what we buy at the vendors is level 30, yeah. like, for add-ons and mods and shit.
And I'm not level
30. 32? No, that's just in the regular game, like, level 30. Yeah. But then once you get your level up, you can buy level 32, level 33 shit in the Dark Zone. So you're getting these, like, extended magazines that are going, mm-hmm. like, 105%, 110%.
I've got some of those right now, though.
Well, 125%.
I don't have any.
And, like, the fucking... it's... yeah.
It's ridiculous.
And you're talking, like, mods and then, like, your add-ons for your backpacks and shit are astounding, but you have to get them in the Dark Zone, which means you have to level up in the Dark Zone. But then the second you go in the Dark Zone and someone just shreds you and you walk out the door...
what's the fucking point?
What's the point? And then you go to a different entrance and there's another group of dudes that are just sitting there wanting to shred people so they can max out their XP.
Oh, yeah.
It's fucking annoying, man. I don't want to play in the Dark Zone, but they force you to have to play in the Dark Zone.
And I haven't in months... I don't plan to again. I mean, I might be willing to, you, me, us three, fucking just go there and be like, so this is the Dark Zone, and I've died.
Yeah. What was the one time we
that
did
was quick.
The last we did not this recent incursion because it doesn't come out until Tuesday for PlayStation. But the last incursion that came out, we went in.
Oh my god!
Yeah,
it was,
we went
it
in.
Was just
it was me, you, and two other guys, two randoms.
Yeah,
and we go in.
Did we play that one too?
Yeah,
because I was gonna say
yeah.
We also played it, and I fucking was going off on this guy for so long. where literally everyone else is, his name was Houston something. I can't remember what the fuck it was. But every single time, all I thought was basically Superman. Houston. What is Houston? And by the third time we tried doing it, everyone was calling him Houston.
And then he
the
left.
The whole fucking time. No, he left by like the seventh attempt.
No, he didn't.
Yes.
That was when it first came out. I'm talking like, but when we went through, like I went through, maybe it was with you.
Yeah.
Me, you, and two randoms. And we go through, and I'm looking at like, someone runs Pulse, and literally, you can't see around the side of the screen because it's all purple lightning bolts.
Yeah.
Like, literally, it had to have been like 40 shotgunners. Like, what the fuck? Like, how am I going to...
Why can't I climb back over this fucking thing and snipe the motherfuckers
Jesus
for a bit?
Jesus Christ, it was horrible. I'm like, what the hell is going on?
Then
it was like, oh, there was some glitches and we're fixing and... Like, and they get pissed at people that are, like, exploiting the game and stuff.
Well, and then they figured out that if, you know, that's what I would do. I would stand outside and shoot in. You know, I'd sit on top of a bus or whatever.
Then they got good at shooting through the bus.
Well, no, and then they decided to start launching the mortars on top of the bus, which they didn't do that before. I found that out the hard way.
It's like...
Well, some people want it to be more challenging.
It's like the developers of the game sit there and go, how can we piss... everybody off.
Well, and it's casual players too. Like I don't, we don't get to play for fucking
no
hours and hours on end. Like we have lives, we have jobs, we have families,
might be able
to
devote a day every 2 weeks towards this.
Maybe get like maybe three and a half hours in.
Yeah,
at once. But it's just getting in there and trying to fucking pop. Like they have that I missed out because it's a level up weekend where the people there's websites you can go to and people will go in and try to help you get gear. You get people with, like, hardcore gamers will help casuals.
Really?
Do stuff, yeah.
Didn't know that.
Rogue Agent Radio started it, I think.
That's
but they
kind
were,
of awesome.
Yeah, they did it with, before the last expansion dropped for Xbox. They were helping people. Now they're doing it for PlayStation people because the expansion comes out on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Which, hopefully, they update and fix a bunch of shit. I can't wait to see
state
of the game.
They're not
going to. But and they wonder why their fucking their playership has dropped
like
drastically.
Out of your atmosphere.
Like it was like it broke into records when it came out, and then it just keeps on blum.
That's the sound of him pooping.
Yeah,
I actually thought it was the sound of a puttering car.
It was. And it sucks because the game is like if they just fix the shit that need to be fixed instead of going, well, we can change this for the Dark Zone. Fuck the Dark Zone.
Well, it's not only that, they make it, you know, okay, people find an exploit, and they do great, and they tell other people, other people come in and do it, and everything's fine and dandy. They fix the ways that we do better at the game instead of making the game better.
They concentrate on what they fucked up in the first place.
Yeah.
Yep.
But a lot of the thing, the funny thing is, like, my opinion on exploits, which goes back to this PokeVision thing, is if you didn't want the game to be played this way, you shouldn't have made it so you couldn't play it this way.
Yeah.
They're like, well, this is not the way we intended it.
Fuck how you intended it.
Well, that's the way I
if
figured
I can,
out. Someone
the road
out,
to hell is paved with good intention.
Goddamn right.
Yeah.
And if I'm a level fucking 30 with really goddamn decent gear overall...
Which you probably have the best gear out of all of us.
Of all of us, I think I do have the best gear, which stuns me on how I do, but still. I should not get my dick handed to me every time we play this fucking game.
Agreed.
I shouldn't literally stop playing, not because of how late it is, but because fuck this game.
Yeah.
That's how I sign off half the time.
I don't know how many times I've actually signed off the game in a decent mood.
No.
I don't think it's been many of them.
I think last time I signed off, I'm like, fuck this. I'm going to go get the Stratini that's down at the fucking park.
You did. You literally did.
Yeah.
I was
no, I was going for a Rhyhorn. It was a Rhyhorn down at the park. And then I get there and it was gone. I missed it by like 2 seconds. And then a Dratini pops up. I'm like, ooh. I'm going to run down here and grab that instead. But yeah, I mean, I'd rather go play Pokemon Go and fucking, what, we drove around for 3.5 hours last night playing Pokemon Go. I'd rather do that than play The Division.
Yeah, and it's just a statement.
It is, because, I mean, it's a fucking great game.
I would much rather play Call of Duty Zombies.
Same. Over The Division right now? Fuck. Absolutely. Every ounce of yes. Even though they've made that so goddamn overtly complicated, so they don't need to.
I want to start playing Diablo again. Diablo 3.
I know you do.
It's fucking... Oh, and they keep on updating it. They keep on adding better shit.
I have never played Diablo.
Yes, you did.
Oh, God, it's fucking
fun. Oh, that's right.
You hated it.
I hated Diablo.
You hated it?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Slash. I've never in my life seen this. I bought him the game. Did I not buy you that one?
I got the trial.
No. We went to fucking the thing, because literally the trial. We went to fucking GameStop.
Not for the PS4.
Oh, God, no. It was for your 360. Or no, your Xbox. Was it 360 or 1?
1.
Probably one.
Had to be one.
Was it the one?
Yeah.
And we got that fucking thing. And literally, your exact response after we finished an hour of play was, "I'm returning this."
Yeah, I believe that.
I love that game.
And the shit, I want to shoot something in the face, and I want to see their face as it explodes. I'm not so much of the, you know.
Well, it's RPG-ish.
Yeah, I. That's which the is thing. Cool.
It's like you have to have like a certain power and blah blah blah.
Which is cool and all.
Yeah.
But no.
Yeah.
God of War was cool. I like that.
Absolutely. And there's a new one coming out, too.
Yeah. Oh, okay. I have to say this. I want them to bring out Mass Effect.
Andromeda.
The entire...
Oh, the whole fucking prequels?
Yeah.
Well, the originals.
Yeah. I want 1 through 4. So I think the fourth one's coming out.
Yeah, Andromeda's coming out. Later this year or next year?
This year.
I think it's right before the holiday.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I'm looking. I've got 2 purchases in mind for the next couple months, maybe 3.
What?
Number 1 is Mass Effect Andromeda.
But here's the problem. Yeah. If you didn't play Mass Effect 1, 2, and 3
mm-hmm.
on that system,
it doesn't keep your choices.
No.
It's an entirely new thing.
Andromeda's supposed to be entirely
different.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a completely different story.
It doesn't take any of the shit
of nothing
what
from your last game.
Oh, see, that
it's,
that
but
twists
it's
my
the
kiss.
Same universe, same person. No, Shepard's not in it.
Shepard's not in it?
Shepard's not supposed to be in it. It's supposed to be someone, I don't know if it's related to Shepard or something, but it's someone like kind of taking up the mantle.
I like Shepard.
I haven't. Like, Mass Effect, I've been more concentrated on Deus Ex than that.
See,
Deus Ex is fucking... Oh!
There's the other one I'm thinking of.
The last what? Game. Oh,
Deus Ex.
Deus Ex, the last game was fucking tits.
I know.
It's a first-person game where you can do stuff.
Where you can do stuff.
Stealth.
Hack.
Oh, stealth.
Stealth. And
you can
hack.
Kill
you can people. You can go through entire levels without killing people if you don't want to.
Why would
you
do
can,
that?
Because you can't.
Hang on. You
can
like
be,
playing...
You can be
You liked playing what the fuck? Dishonored. You liked Dishonored.
Yeah, but you can go through that and
you can
go through that
kill everyone in that.
Yes, you did, but the other option, there's ways of doing it without killing a single fucking person in the whole game.
Because you can. It's just it's giving the players options.
Because trophies.
Which is great, but murder, death, kill.
Basically, it's doing what The Division doesn't want people to do. Play however the fuck you want.
Yeah. We don't like the way that you're using this weapon too much, so we're going to nerf it.
Yeah.
That
did you really like your submachine gun?
That's shit.
Too bad.
Yeah.
My number one weapon for the longest time was that Vesper.
Oh, yeah. You
Vespa.
Love that thing.
Vespa?
The Vespa.
Oh, Vector.
Vector.
Vespa.
I see you just riding around on the street.
The Vespa.
Yours would be hot pink, I'm just saying.
No, it'd be blue, and I'd call it Sasha.
Just like your... Back off, man, I'm a scientist. T-shirt.
I could rock a hot pink one. I'm not going to lie.
That's what I rock... Fucking both my weapons are hot pink snakeskin.
But there's the new Deus Ex, the fucking Andromeda one, and No Man's Sky. I'm looking forward to that one.
I don't know.
At the exact same time,
I'm getting kind of skeptical on it.
That's what I'm saying. Over the last couple weeks, I've been sitting there listening to some of the updates. I'm like,
what do you mean? Someone's
saying it might be boring as fuck because there's not going to, like, you're going to go to a planet and it's going to be. They're saying at points. Because some of the planets, the way that they're made up, since it's completely random, that at that point you might not be able to survive on that planet, so you might, like, spawn for the first time and just die.
Yeah.
And have to start over. But they don't know what planet's going to do it because it's like it's completely random.
It uses you don't know what it uses the Drake equation. Among yeah, other things.
Which I mean, and then which the, now they're getting in trouble for one, that.
That's kind of fucking awesome, though.
Well, they're using I guess the company that owns that equation. They're yeah. using that without permission.
Yeah, they are. But still,
which, and they just got out of the lawsuit with Sky Vodka because they own the word Sky.
Do they really?
Yeah. That's why what was it Sky Computing? Not Sky Computing. Sky Cloud or whatever Skyball? they're using for. It was a Microsoft product. It was supposed to be Sky something, and they had to change the name because Sky Vodka sued them.
Fucking Christ.
Sky Vodka.
I think it's Sky Vodka it owns the word Sky.
They can't own the word fuck Sky.
They trademarked the word Sky. So
that's impossible.
How do people do that?
That's impossible.
And how can I do it with all the other words?
I'm going to trademark the word fuck since it's my favorite.
It's also Nick's favorite when we're around children. Jesus Christ, dude. I'm gonna get you a job in peace. Oh, that's fucking great, dude. There's a
fucking yes.
6-year-old right next to us.
I'm good at this. I can turn it off.
I can turn it off. Fuck. I can fucking turn it off.
I can turn the fuck off whenever I fucking
want
to. It's like
I'm talking to my mom. Introduce her to my wife. The first time, like when I was first dating my wife, and I'm like, all right, mom, I'm bringing Susan over. And, you know, she's from the South. So the whole Southern hospitality, she's a Southern Belle type thing. She doesn't really swear a lot, you know. You kind of tone it down a little bit. Tell me to watch my fucking mouth? Yes, Mom.
Yes, tell you watch your fucking mouth. Your fucking mouth. I love her so much.
Oh, I miss her.
I know.
So, other things other than the Division. Deus Ex, which is... if it's anything like the last game, you're not going to see me for a while. Well, you know, I'm not going to Deus Ex, leave me alone. Which would be cool if it had a multiplayer.
I would love if it had a multiplayer. Yes. But at the same time, it's one of those that doesn't make sense.
Is there a lot of games that have multiplayer? That's the thing. I would like to see more co-op, like how...
Yes.
Borderlands.
That'd be cool.
Borderlands was tits co-op.
Yeah.
Oh my god, it was fun co-op. Let's see another one of those, actually. That'd be nice to have a new...
I used to be a Destiny freak. I enjoyed playing the Destiny.
I've not gotten into it yet.
I still need to get a copy for PlayStation. I don't know if I can port over my...
Here's the thing.
My Xbox character?
That sucks.
I've sworn you can port over Xbox ones. No?
That fucking sucks.
Because I was a very high level on my Xbox One. And then Xbox One died. So I got my PlayStation 4 and I started over. And, you know, this is the part of gaming that twists my tits. I worked really hard to get to the high level I was when I was level 34. And now, for free, if you just start the game...
Oh, they give you the 25?
You become level 25.
Yeah. Well, that was something they gave you that in one of the updates. They gave you, you can start a new character and instantly it was a gem or something you got, and it would take you instantly to 25.
Yeah, it's bullshit.
Yeah.
And for me, on top of everything else, though, I personally, we know so many people that I would love to play with.
Yeah.
That's Mommy's controller. I'd love to play with her.
Yeah.
She's fucking great. Her husband's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
But I'd love to play with them, but they're so much fucking higher level that I'd sit there and go,
What we can do is we can start and we can, because since I'm going to have to start over, we can start and jump in at the same time.
Are they the same game or is it,
what?
You have to get like the new, is it a different game?
Well, they got an expansion coming out. So there's the Taken King edition, which has all the expansions in it, which was available on Amazon not too long ago for cheap. But I think that they might have gone up with the new,
the next expansion.
The next expansion, which is the Rise of Iron.
Which I know nothing about.
Yeah, this but if you got portion. The Return of the King, you got the...
Return of the King is on Amazon for $37.95 right now.
But that was...
But that's all three expansions plus the vanilla game.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying it's not that bad. Like, I'm still looking to get you fucking Black Ops Zombies just so we have a chance.
The new expansion is $30.
It's all...
But it's supposed to be some sweet shit, too.
But see, they're giving you an expansion where it's $30, so when all is said and done, if you bought the game when it first came out...
60.
$69.99 or 60,
$70. Whatever. Let's just say 70.
Say 70, and then you need the season pass. Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Another 50 or $60 for that.
It's usually a $60 for season pass, which is three expansions. So everyone's going to pay for this one because usually season passes only last for three expansions.
Right. Then that's what I'm saying. On top of that, now comes this expansion where you have to pay another $30.
Or you're going to have to buy a version with the Rise Iron already in it.
Yeah, so you're paying $160
if you got in on the game at the ground floor.
Yeah, yeah. Like I did.
Which is bullshit.
Absolutely.
Because you're paying for
you should be grandfathered
two and a half games.
You should be grandfathered in.
Or at least get a discount.
Well, now, say this. Supposedly, loyalty that this program. Expansion pack is supposed to be an entire game.
Well, that's what they said with The Taken King. It's supposed to be like, it's an entire campaign. But a lot of it is they're using different aspects of the game, like different levels of the game.
Yeah.
But they're like areas you couldn't go before, you can go in now. Which is kind of cool, but at the same time, they did the same thing in Taken King. And they did, all their expansions kind of bleed off the same game. Like, the same levels.
Yeah.
So it's like, you're still back in that grind. Like, oh, I remember this place.
Yeah,
oh,
they're not adding enough new. To me, it's they're not adding enough to justify me paying $30
for expansion. I don't know. I haven't seen the new. I haven't heard anything about it. It's not out yet, I don't think.
I know nothing about what we're talking about at the moment.
That's okay.
Yeah.
We're used to it.
Right now it's $30 for the pre-order.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
Yeah. I'm not going to either, to be honest. I mean,
I could probably
be talked into it, let's be honest.
Oh, well, yeah, you
but can. Right now, I have no intention.
You need to play Zombies, sir.
He was gonna upload that on my PlayStation while I was on vacation.
Why didn't you?
He's watching the dog because I was disconnected to the internet so I could fuck up Fallout. I was I didn't download any of the updates to Fallout so I could use all the cheats. So I didn't have my PlayStation hooked up to the internet. So when he went to go do it, he's like, "Oh, but I can't get on the internet." I'm like, don't you fucking mess with my settings.
Yeah, I was going to literally with my own money buy him the download of fucking the DLC for fucking. The thing.
And you so I it. Just said, fuck it, and came home. When I came home, I'm like, I can't play Division. All I can play is Fallout, because you didn't have to be online for Fallout. I said, fuck it. And then PlayStation, what was it the night we were going to play? PlayStation took an hour to update software.
Literally, we didn't play that night.
We didn't play, because
you were like, all right, dude, I'm going to get home, I'm going to fucking hook my shit back up, and then I will, you know, we'll play... It'll probably take like half an hour, maybe.
Yeah.
And we'll play for the next couple hours. Cool. Yeah. And it, by the time it had finished downloading, it was almost 2.
Yeah.
Everything.
It was bad. It was bad. I was tired. I was like, fuck it, I'm going to bed.
I know. We both said, fuck it, I'm going to bed.
Yeah.
Bye tomorrow. Let's see. What else you guys want to talk about?
Cops are awesome.
Cops are awesome.
Joseph Fan of Police.
Since he was one.
Yeah,
I think everybody's awesome. Just there's bad people that do stupid things.
And I want to kill them all.
Makes it bad for everybody. What about bad cops?
Kill them.
There you go.
Jesus Christ. For fuck's sake. Okay.
If you ever stand in front of my there? Car, if you ever stand in front of my car, I'm gonna run you the fuck over. I have to go to work.
Edit number 2. All right.
Get out of my way. Edit. Why?
Let's be honest, I'm too lazy to edit this shit.
What? Hey, hey.
Nick just looking all fucking like, yeah, no shit, motherfucker. No. Wasn't there a 3-hour podcast of being shit-faced drunk?
That was entertaining as sin for me. Yeah. I was crying laughing.
I still have to go back and listen. I haven't listened the whole thing
yet. While we're doing a podcast, would you guys like to taste something?
No.
What is it?
Straight down.
Alcohol.
What kind of alcohol?
Alcohol.
Is it like rubbing alcohol?
Is it, like, why would I give you rubbing alcohol?
Is it bourbon? Is it wine? Is it beer?
It's Shine.
Oh, shit. Is it straight Shine?
It's straight up homemade Shine.
Homemade Shine.
Homemade
like,
Shine.
You made this?
No.
Just pants?
Is it flavored at all?
No.
Straight
up American Muscle Shine.
Oh, shit. My bitches.
No. Well, here. You can start with this. You can start with the caramel.
Yeah, let's start with fucking this moonshine first.
No, this is Firefly moonshine. This is
Not moonshine.
30% alcohol. Yeah. 60 proof.
No. You just put that one the fuck back away. Who's that?
Someone I know makes, was it apple pie moonshine?
Oh my god, that sounds good.
And it's like throw you on your ass moonshine, well, but it tastes like fucking apples.
I'd like that.
That's Mountain Dew. That's not moonshine. Oh, never mind.
That's a lot of Mountain Dew.
There it is.
I think Joe has a stock in Mountain Dew.
I think he might.
I think there's a truck.
If he doesn't, he really the fuck
should.
Yeah,
he really should.
Because by now he'd made money back from it, I think. It's fully clear moonshine.
Things that come in random bell jars just never turn out to be a good idea.
Nope. Big fucking nope. Oh well. What, it's gonna melt the fucking cup, asshole?
It's not.
I know, it's not. I don't think.
This is, by far, gentlemen, the strongest shit you're ever going to taste.
Are we really going to taste it?
Yeah, you are.
I'll give it a whirl.
I'll have a sip.
I'm going to need a Mountain Dew with this, though.
Go ahead.
Yeah, could you grab me one, too, while you're at it? All right. We've
chases are permitted with
we're
this.
Officially we're officially asking for a Mountain Dew to promote our...
Yeah, on top of it, now we're also in the... Let's try this portion of the cast.
Ecto Cooler, it's right there.
Oh, I know, I brought him some. Oh my god, my hand is warm where the moisture's touched it.
And he's taking this out of the refrigerator.
I know. Are you not having any, Joe?
My meds, I can't.
You want him to pass out and start having convulsions?
Not really.
Could be good for the cast.
It would be. I don't have the fucking camera on me, so that wouldn't be as good for the camera.
Well, with the meds that I'm on, currently. You're not. Alcohol is too. It says do not mix. It doesn't say.
Advise not to.
It's not a good idea. Or
I mean, my fucking.
Or you shouldn't.
My shit says that. I don't give a fuck.
No, normally it says you shouldn't.
This says don't. Well, that's because it has issues with your stomach lining and shit.
Well,
like
because
that.
It would probably make the problem wake up.
It's funny, the antibiotics I was on, and I was drinking bourbon with it, and it had nothing on it that said, do not take drink alcohol. That shit shredded my stomach.
Oh, yeah.
Shredded. All right,
gentlemen. Please raise your glasses. Let's do a toast.
Hold on, let me have the glass first. Yeah, crack. I like that we've now added a new segment on Geek Eclectic.
Let's drink something random.
Random alcoholic purchases.
Random booze at Joe's.
Try this.
Here's the Fallen Cops.
Agreed.
Oh, I'm gonna film this
I'm
shit.
I'm filming it already.
Hold on, let me film it. Because this is gonna be fun.
Alright.
Okay, we're gonna try this one by one.
Oh, yeah.
I love bourbon. This is just not, I don't like clear liquor.
I have bourbon too.
Maybe it's a chaser.
Are you feeding me this? Is that turpentine? Oh.
It is not empty. By a long shot.
No.
No, you have to finish it.
It tastes like someone drank turpentine and tequila and then took a piss in my glass.
You have to finish it, sir. It's important.
You don't have to finish it.
You do.
I don't have to finish it in one second, so you can continue filming, but you're going to wait a minute.
All right, well, I will pause.
That is warm.
Now it's time
That is
Nick.
Warm.
I've already started drinking it, actually, while you're doing
I am my entire body. I just started sweating.
Oh, dude.
Yeah.
Fuck me. All right, this is going to be interesting.
Oh.
Come on, let's do it. Remember the old movies where you go like this?
Or photography that's made me money? Yeah.
Do it. Do it all.
I regret everything.
Do it all.
Fuck no.
Just be a man.
Look what you're talking to with that one, son.
Exactly. Do it.
I know. I had a story I was going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you it now.
Oh my god, you didn't even taste any. All you did was smell it.
Oh no, I fucked.
Weird tequila you taste?
Yes.
I hate tequila.
Absolutely weird tequila you taste.
Alright, I stopped it.
Isn't moonshine corn? Isn't that corn mash?
I don't know. Full honesty. Alright, well that don't worry, we're gonna keep drinking it, but Jesus fucking Christ, that ends the video portion of the cast.
Oh my god, that was horrible.
If you guys would like, I can get other types of alcohol out. I have plenty.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
Right now.
And
I'm good with trying to finish this. Yeah. I like how you're nowhere near the mic for all this. It's good. You're too close, Nick. You're too close, man.
Riddle me this, Nicky. I'm whispering to you.
I hear you.
All quietly.
I hear
at
you.
The mic.
Now. For fuck's sake.
Why do you have bourbon in your freezer?
Oh, you got the fucking in the freezer. You got the fucking skull.
Is this the Dan Aykroyd?
Hey, come on in, Carrie. This is Joe's wife.
This is Dan
She's coming
Aykroyd.
In right now.
This is the Dan Aykroyd?
This
Dan Aykroyd
is
crystal
the
skull.
Dan Aykroyd crystal skull.
As you thump it in front of the microphone.
Oh, my bad. Yep.
You know that that's worth some money, right?
No, not anymore.
No?
Why, no. They've done like 11 runs so far.
Okay.
Yeah. This is not a first run edition. But I do have that if you'd like to taste it.
No, okay.
The
tequila as well?
That's straight vodka.
Okay.
I actually probably will before we leave.
Well,
Carrie's coming in right now. Hi, Carrie.
Hi.
Hi.
You're on the podcast.
Awesome.
That's my wife. She's hot.
Thanks, baby.
Bourbon in the freezer. Oh, why bourbon in the freezer?
Right now we're just doing show and tell at this point.
No, we're pulling out something.
It's
doing.
No, we're good. We have the shine. We still have to finish.
I'm good. Jesus Christ!
I have too many. There's too many.
You guys like Red Stag?
No, we had Red Stag. Do you not remember this? Wait, hang on. That question itself is stupid. Nope.
Apple? Crown Apple.
I don't like Crown at all.
Fireball.
Like Crown's not bad. Regular Crown. I can drink.
I have the Morgan 100 proof. I have a gallon of tequila.
And now we have coasters.
Yay, coasters.
Ooh, I like coasters.
I want to give a shout out right quick.
Joe is going to have a shout out shortly, since he's actually near the microphone.
Cleveland Underground. Wicked Awesome Bourbon.
Is it called Wicked Awesome Bourbon?
No. Okay. I'm saying it is Wicked Awesome. this is batch one.
Nice.
First batch.
Cheaper in your freezer.
Yeah. You should never keep bourbon in the freezer.
I keep it in the freezer.
You should never keep
it. I keep it in the freezer.
You should never keep it.
Don't judge me for keeping it in the freezer.
He's the bartender.
I know nothing about alcohol.
90
He keeps all the liquor in the freezer.
It's really bad.
Yeah, I keep everything in
except
the freezer.
Except for the decanter.
It's actually bad for the alcohol.
Carrie's now.
It is bad for the alcohol.
Carrie's now compulsively placing coasters everywhere.
Shit. I'm dead serious. Why do you think,
dude,
like,
it's an old wood table.
Keeping like warm beer getting warm
Look,
is horrible.
You're not
for
even
beer.
Using the coaster I put
so
out for you.
Beer you keep cold. Liquor you keep warm.
Liquor, then sticker.
Really?
I've heard someone getting fired for that. That.
Me?
Liquor, I don't even know her.
It's terrible.
Did you count the liquor tonight? Liquor, I don't even know her. And he got fired.
All right, Carrie, say bye to the cast.
Bye, everyone.
That was Carrie. Round of applause from home.
Golf clap.
Two fingers for the golf.
I know, but I wanted them to hear.
Oh, that's nice. For fuck's sake.
So, do we want me to get into my rants?
What are we ranting about?
I have many things I can rant
about.
Video
game thing? This is mostly video game and geeky shit.
He does not have
no
for this.
No. Let's do, we can talk. What else? Can we go
what do you mean I don't?
Oh, no. I just meant your rants were for video games. Or, you know, television. And no, I don't count things that are on television as television.
It was about to be about television.
I'm going to give you 30 seconds on this one.
Okay.
Let's set a timer on this one. Let's set a timer.
I'm sorry. God
damn it. Timer.
All right.
Hold on. And
I drank more of it.
I'm
so not happy right now.
Alright, well, here's the deal.
Go.
I am a grave injustice has been done to the American people. And that is the fact that Justified is no longer running and Deadwood.
Which one's Justified?
I'll give you that.
Those two shows
were freaking excellent. Okay.
Are absolutely
stopping the timer
excellent.
This is something we can talk about.
This is fine. If it stays on this kind of shit,
and,
I'm fine with it.
And I'm very upset. Now, all truth out here, I have not finished Justified yet.
Never.
I just started season two, and it is one of the best
shows that I've seen. My timer is going off. Sorry, I hit the timer.
It is, but Deadwood to me was probably one of my top five favorite shows.
He changed some of his verbiage, bringing back something of that. I guess there was talks of some of the cast members wanting to do something. It wouldn't be called Deadwood, it'd be something else.
It'd be called Wormwood.
Well, a lot of the people from Deadwood are in Justified.
Yeah.
But, okay, I want to see if I can blow your brains. A cross. Justified, Sons of Anarchy.
I've never watched Justified. It's good. Never seen it.
Like it.
I think you'd like it.
It's like a Southern cop show.
Yeah.
Almost Shield-ish.
Okay.
Points.
Doesn't that Woody Harrelson? Was Woody Harrelson in that one or is the other one?
No. This was shit. What's his name?
Oh, what's his name? The fucking guy that now drives
Olafimf.
Owen Wilson.
No.
This is why they made IMDb.
Owen.
God damn it. Is it not the guy that's in the Cadillac commercials now?
No.
I want to drive around, talk about shit. What show is he in?
Rolling Boogers. No, show. He was on that.
He was on a television show recently. Yes, he was. Him
really?
And Colin Farrell was
No.
Too.
There was True Homicide.
True
Detective, yeah.
See, that's what I thought you guys were talking about. I had no idea the other one.
Oh, no, this is a show. Well, first we'll start with Deadwood since it's, you know, only lasted three seasons. It's amazing.
Some of my biggest bitches are ones that didn't last two.
Timothy Oliphant.
There it is, Oliphant. Now, my problem is with Deadwood, that show, it was way back Cowboys and Indians style, mm-hmm. Okay?
It had, Wild Bill Hickok?
Yep, Wild Bill Hickok was part of it, and it's filmed in the same place where he was killed, same way he was killed. I mean, it's all there, but it kind of gives you a sense of the Old West and not just a cowboy shoot-em-up shit that you'd see.
I love Ian McShane.
There are boobies.
I've watched Deadwood. I loved Deadwood.
Yes. I love boobies in Deadwood. That was a great show.
Yes.
And Justified.
I love boobies most anywhere.
Okay, think of Oliphant's.
Jim Beaver was in Deadwood.
Jim Beaver.
He was.
Give me a picture.
Bobby on Supernatural.
Give me a picture. Oh, wait, no, I know who Bobby is. Yeah. I sat there. I was like, before he showed me the picture, people.
You know who else was on it? Jeffrey Jones was on it.
Yes.
Now he's in jail for child molestation or something.
Give me a picture.
Yeah, the principal from Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yeah, he's in jail.
Nine times.
He was also in Beetlejuice.
Yes.
He's also in Beetlejuice. Is that why they're not doing another Beetlejuice, you think?
Probably. They're worried about where the juice comes from. So, Justified, you take that same character that Tim Oliphant played, same character, modern day. Kind of skirts the law, doesn't really break the law, but doesn't really stay on the good side of the law either.
They've got a show like that right now. Luther.
I have not seen
Luther borders the fucking, he breaks the law half the time in the show. He breaks the fucking law to make it so that people that are just outside of justice's fucking reach are in its reach. Luther's a great fucking show.
I think...
And it's, what's his name? He's in the Thor movies, too.
Thor's awesome.
And he's in the new Star Trek, too. Idris Elba, yeah.
I saw the new Star Trek.
How'd you like it? I enjoyed the shit out of it. I actually went to go see it. I saw it... Incidentally, they didn't have a showing in normal. In normal. I only saw it in 3D, and... Me with glasses and 3D, not always my favorite thing, but I enjoyed the piss out of that fucking movie.
I did not.
Really?
Well, no. Okay. I think the movie was a good movie.
Damn right.
I have a problem when the future, and I'm saying this in regards to
Star Trek. Do you mind if he spoils this slightly?
What movie is it?
Star Trek.
Yeah, I'm going to show.
Okay.
Nick's
putting aside his love for Star Trek.
Yes, because I love it so much.
It's so good.
The new movies are entertaining.
Yeah, they are.
But they got a new show coming out. It's going to be good, hopefully. Have you seen the ship? It looks like dog shit. Well, straight up.
Let me finish my story.
Keep going.
Go ahead.
God.
Sorry.
I don't like how the future in the Star Trek world no longer is applicable at all.
Explain. What do you mean?
Well, in the first Star Trek, I believe...
the new ones, you mean?
The new one, okay. I believe... where's Spock from?
Vulcan.
Vulcan. Vulcan was destroyed.
Yes.
In the first movie.
In
the first movie.
And there are, what do you call it, refugees from Vulcan.
Yeah.
Well, new Vulcan.
And now, right. Now they've formed new Vulcan.
Right.
New planet.
But in the old shows,
mm-hmm.
old movies,
yep.
it's not destroyed.
Absolutely correct.
Well, they've changed a lot in the new
It's
movies.
A new, it's a new universe.
It's a new universe.
You can't say it's a new universe when Spock comes back.
It's,
but that was supposed to
it
be
uses,
Spock from the future
yes.
going back.
It's
time.
Not only Spock
yes.
from the future, it's
it's actual alternate reality.
It uses a concept that is highly theorized, but is called the multiverse theory.
I understand multiverse, but what I'm saying
he
is...
He came from one to another one.
He came back with a picture of
his
crew.
Yes. And it doesn't look like him. Some of them actually look pretty fucking similar
yes,
overall.
But gave it to young Spock.
Yep. Quinto
this
Spock.
This is your... You know, your future.
It wasn't that he gave it to him for that. It was a some of his
belongings
and he willed them to him.
Now, he sees this and he sees, okay, this is everything that happened. And now, he can go through and read all of the things that happened.
Oh, no, he doesn't have a book of this shit. He just has some pictures that he has from when they were...
But everything that's happened didn't happen...
No.
In his
correct
present,
because shit changed.
Time.
Yeah, because as soon as the Narada, destroyed the Kelvin and killed Kirk's father.
Yep,
also known as Thor. As soon as he killed Kirk's father,
who's supposed to be in the fourth movie,
possibly.
No,
which I think it's going to be flashbacks.
Written,
I think it's going to be some flashbacks.
I believe so.
Yes.
I don't think they're going to fuck with timing.
It's
I don't
already
think it's
doing
be a
script and everything. Already planning production.
But as soon as it destroyed the Kelvin. Everything that would have normally been changed. The whole timeline that would have become was altered.
I don't like
they all
because a different choice was made. Therefore, multi-universe theory says it spreads out and fucking starts to almost...
It changes. It changes
yeah.
its trajectory that what it was supposed to happen. Now
yeah.
it doesn't because
right.
it was changed.
Now, taking that,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to bring up Terminator.
Gotcha.
Oh, God. I just watched Genesis with my son the other day.
How bad was that?
It wasn't horrible.
That's it was visually good.
It was visually
well,
good.
Let's be honest.
But there was a
how
lot
bad
of,
did you think it was going to be when you watched
I thought it?
It
was going to be dog shit.
Yeah.
But it wasn't
lowered
like it wasn't horrible, but they got really into the multiverse thing and like the future changing and then like times changing and like my son's like, "Daddy, what happened? I don't know. What's Genesis? Who's Genesis?" I'm like, "Well, Genesis is actually technically Skynet. Why don't they call it Skynet? Cuz it's different cuz things changed." So now they changed the name.
Genesis is a weapon that they used on a planet to change it to be one that can support life.
Wrong movie.
Wrong movie.
Now, but if you think about it, now,
still in
now,
conversation.
I'm gonna go, I want to go all the way back. I'm going to go all the way back to the very first
Terminator.
All right. Sarah Connor.
Okay. Arnold comes back to kill her. Right?
T-800.
Now, what's his name?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Kyle Reese.
Fucking Kyle Reese comes back to save her.
Yes.
Okay. Now, who sent Kyle Reese back?
That would be
John
Connor.
Connor.
Who is John Connor?
John Connor is the son of Sarah Connor,
and
the child of Kyle Reese.
Yes.
Okay. So, Kyle Reese was sent back in time.
Circular.
But at the time, they didn't know that Kyle Reese was the father.
Right.
That was the thing.
Kyle Reese is not knowing his father, but he's the father. He comes back in time,
mm-hmm.
fucks Sarah,
yes,
boom, baby, okay?
Yes, John Connor.
Leads the resistance.
Now, John Connor sends him back in time
How is that his... How
is that his dad?
How is that his dad?
Causation.
Because it was... Just, it's the way the timeline went. He goes
the
back.
The timeline doesn't fit.
He goes back. He
it's always a
timeline.
Circular point.
But my, I heard cannot I come back in time.
I heard a description that I like.
From if you set me back in time, mm-hmm. because I'm your father, okay? I'm your dad. Mm-hmm. You send me back in time, the very first time.
You weren't.
And I've never met her. Mm-hmm. I don't know her. Mm-hmm. I've never been back in time before. Mm-hmm. How the fuck can you be my father? Or how the fuck can I be your father?
There you go. Fixed it. All right. The explanation I've heard recently that I actually very much liked was that overall, Kyle Reese's life is a circular portion of a universe. Is that overall, Kyle Reese was always destined to go back because of all that happened. Originally, the T-800 was probably sent back to kill Sarah Connor because of it, of her child that would be born either way, whether it be from fucking Kyle Reese or otherwise. And because of that, it is now a continual loop. For Kyle Reese, his life begins with whatever the fuck he did before the whole, you know, Genesis or Skynet or whatever the fuck you want to call it, yep. popped up. And his life would always go back to 84 to fucking help Sarah Connor, blah, 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 blah. But in doing so, he became the father of John Connors, the person that sent him. And then from then on, it literally just stayed inside that loop.
No, because if Skynet or Genesis, whatever it is called, is not there, mm-hmm. he would have no reason to be sent back.
He's always going to be there, though.
Well, no. He wouldn't. He if Skynet never existed.
Okay.
Say,
they succeeded in movie two.
To destroy
Skynet. Destroying
Skynet.
Mm-hmm. Okay, it's gone.
Then John shouldn't be born.
Correct.
Right.
But would that change? Because it's something from.
Well, no, John would be born.
No,
he wouldn't be. He wouldn't be born from Kyle Reese.
Right.
He'd be born from somebody else.
Yes.
Maybe.
Probably.
She was in the nut house. Sarah Connor was in the nut house.
In two.
In
one.
Yes.
No, in one she wasn't.
So in that time period, between her getting caught, she could have gotten pregnant.
By somebody.
By someone random.
But then it would not be.
Because he even said he had other stepfathers and stuff.
Right, but it wouldn't be John Connor.
Dudes that could teach her shit.
But it wouldn't be John Connor. It would not have the same physical characteristics.
It wouldn't have the same physical characteristics. But at the same time, it would still be she could still name him John, and his name would be John Connor.
Right, but I'm saying the John Connor from the future sending
back
his father, okay, it would not be the same guy.
Yes and no. Because the exact same time, didn't he send him back in this one, and he said that he was there going back to save his mother and blah, 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 and...
Yeah.
He had sent him before, and he knew that he was doing it, blah, shit, blah. Did that happen in Genesis?
I didn't watch him saying that, like, I've done this before. No, it was, you're going back to save my mom. And then at one point, there, when the John Connor comes to their time period, which that is kind of weird.
Yeah.
Because Skynet evolves to the point where it turns into a nanomachine, molecular organism, and can take over human life. And turn that into a Terminator.
Which is plausible.
Which, yeah.
It's scarily actually more accurate than a lot of the things that happened previously.
Yeah. So when he comes back, he kind of I think it was like 3/4 of the movie, he ruins it and says, come on, Dad, and like calls him Dad.
Yeah.
But he like purposely did that just to freak people out because he was actually being
smartass.
Smartass the whole time. Technically, all right, Kyle Reese never came back. John Connor
wouldn't be the person that sent him back.
Wouldn't be the person that sent him back because Skynet wouldn't exist. There would be no reason to send him back.
The fun part about all this, though, they actually kind of answered this question in the Sarah Connor Chronicles, which I only know of because I actually heard someone discussing this and not actually saw the fucking thing. But John Connor, in the show, went forward in time to around the same time that they sent Kyle Reese back. And they had no idea who the fuck John Connor was. Had nothing about any of the shit that was going on. Didn't know who Sarah Connors was a freedom fighter for them. But they had no idea who the fuck John Connor was, period. Because obviously he took himself out of the timeline until that point. it was really interesting, but they literally, that was the season two finale, which became the series finale.
Yeah.
So they never discussed anything beyond that or what the hell changed.
Yeah, I don't like it.
It was just kind of weird, but it was like, the part of it was kind of cute, with like Arnold, like becoming more, like the T-800 becoming more human.
Mm-hmm.
Like they find a point where like, Kyle Reese is looking around the bunker and he's got pictures and like stuff that she colored with like him as like the dad figure and stuff like that, and he saved that stuff, so it was kind of cute. And then you get to the whole, like the end of the movie where you think he's dead and he's not, because they had the whole, they were trying to make the T-1000s with the liquid metal ones, but
yeah.
It said, oh, it needs like this certain interface to work, and then he gets thrown into it at the end, and like he's like literally a torso. And all of a sudden he shows back up, like, what the hell happened? He's got the metal arm, like he goes, you got the liquid metal.
Nice.
So he was back, and it was like, oh, it's a happy ending when he's still alive. It's great. And then they set it up for
another one.
T-1800, nice.
Yeah. That's a series like Star Trek that will never end.
Yeah.
Well, luckily Star Trek's not going to end for a good reason, though. So.
But like, I
haven't found the good reason for that.
Yeah. I can see why people said it was a horrible movie, because there was a lot of shit. It was a lot of information, and it was a lot of stuff, like a storyline that you're not looking to follow through a Terminator movie.
You're looking for,
like you say, murder, death, kill.
Yes.
I mean, the action sequences were sweet. Some of the stuff that they had was awesome. Mm-hmm. Like, was it the magnetic shotgun rounds and shit like that? It was like, oh, that's sweet. But, like, a lot of the ways, like, they figured out how to, like, fight the new Terminator and shit like that was awesome. But then... it was kind of like, all right, what the fuck's going on? What, this is happening? And then this is like, it was like my son, who's, Desmond's pretty smart.
Yeah.
He was just like, Daddy, I don't understand what's going on.
And how
is he back here?
I didn't understand it.
Yeah. And it's just like, all right, it's a timeline thing. And then trying to tell him about multiverse theory and.
M theory is hard to explain to a child.
To a 7-year-old.
Any fucking level of intelligence.
Yeah. So yeah, it was just
even one of smart.
It was kind of a pain in the butt, and then I still gotta find him a set with all the Terminator movies. Now his new thing is Predator.
Awesome,
nice. Yeah, I'm kind of like, ooh, baby, I don't know if I should get the first Predator movie. Like, why? Because skinning people alive.
Yeah,
I'm like, I can.
But you don't see the skinning alive.
But you see the skinned bodies.
Well, yeah. You can teach him about anatomy.
That's when I can come over and be like, "That's his liver.
That's the liver."
That.
That's like Victor Lawrence. He's just like, "Daddy, I'm going to see something Predator." And I'm going through on demand, and they had Predators free, which was probably not one of the best movies.
No, it was not.
What you should do, sir, is get a Fire Stick, an Amazon Fire Stick.
Yes, I told you about this.
And let me fix it for you.
Yeah, you talked about that.
Yes,
I told
you. Anyways, of course. You actually told me about it. You were telling me about it.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, I told you. But one of the things that I had to get into, he's like, why is it Alien versus Predator? Like, oh, that's a big can of worms. You're talking Daddy's favorite movies, can of worms. He's like, well, what's the aliens? And I had to go through and I had to explain to him, like, why there's Alien, and then Aliens, then Alien 3, then Alien Resurrection, and now they're doing Alien 5, which is supposed to ignore Alien 3.
Good choice.
Well, I don't know if it's going to be a dream or what they're going to do with it, or like it's going to be something where, but it's supposed to be
snow globe.
Hicks and Newt and Sigourney Weaver back on Earth.
All right,
and the aliens come to Earth.
That's a sound good.
Yeah, all right. Interesting. The xenomorphs.
I'd watch that.
But that's along with they're also doing another
Prometheus.
So it's going to be. Right up to the point of Alien.
Yeah.
What?
It'll actually
Prometheus?
Prequel, which is Prometheus.
Which was, it's supposed to be the prequel of Alien. Michael Fassbender's the android. I'm trying to remember the chick from the... The
girl with dragon tattoo.
Was that her?
Was there a guy trapped under an ancient door?
What?
Was there like a dude trapped under a dead guy trapped underneath an ancient door, or something like that?
Ancient door? You're thinking Abyss.
Like eggs.
There were
a bunch of eggs and like this shit was acid.
But it was a weird like.
Was the water like acid?
I don't remember. I don't remember. I didn't watch. I didn't like sit and watch it the whole time.
I'm gonna have to watch it now.
I'm going to have to pull it up on my Amazon stick.
Trying to explain to him all the... Well, then with the xenomorphs, I'm like, it's the aliens, and they bleed blood, and they do this. Like, well, why do the predators hunt them? they're bad people. They go to planets, and they pretty much just take them over so they can breed off of whatever life form's there. It's like, oh. And because I was, like, going through stuff on Wikipedia, and, like, reading him, like, well, like what the prize of a predator, mm-hmm. I'm trying to remember the name of the race, is...
Predator.
No, they got, like, some weird... It sounds almost like... Native American-ish, is their prize, like, to be, like, a master hunter for them, you have a skull of a queen xenomorph. And it's funny, because if you watch Predator 2, when Danny Glover's going through the ship, you see a xenomorph skull, but you don't see, like, there's no queen on board. But there's, you see a xenomorph skull, like, the weird, it's got a long elongated back and the weird, ooh, like, ribs in it.
Not to say that fucking name, right?
Yeah.
Try it.
Yatuja or a Hishkuten?
Hishkuten?
Hishkuten.
It'd be Japanese-ish.
H-I-S-H.
But those dudes are just so badass. Q-U-slash. Like, that's, like, they have, like, the, like, you go through, like, the list of weapons. Like, I was going over the weapons with them where they have the, was the, was, they might have the pulse cannon or whatever they have on their shoulder. That thing's badass. And I think when you become a, like, a hunter instead of a youngling, you get the pulse cannon on the shoulder. And, like, even, like, Alien vs. Predator, I thought could have been so much better. Mm-hmm. Like, it was disappointing, to say the least.
I don't think I was disappointed with it.
Well, they got all bitch-titted, and, like, dude, how are these three dudes going? It was probably their trial or whatever to go through, and, you know, that was their trial, and so they weren't, like, experienced hunters.
Yeah.
There's a lot of weapons.
Yes.
I'm not even a third of the way through the fucking page.
Yeah. It's a ton of shit.
I've been scrolling since you asked the question.
From Predator 2.
I believe you mean the combi stick. A telescopic spear.
Yes.
Yep. The gauntlet plasma bolt, the power glove, laser net, sword, net gun, plasma caster.
Plasma caster, that's what it is. The shoulder mounted plasma caster. The shotgun. Jesse Ventura got... Right to the chest. No, he got it to the back and it blew out his chest. Oh, it's great. They explained to him that, like, predators only hurt people that have weapons. Like, because in all the movies, it's the thing, they're bred by heat and conflict.
Yeah.
And they only hunt people that had weapons.
Yeah.
There was, like, the one scene in Predator 2 where he...
I thought predators, they still hunted them even though they didn't have weapons.
No, there was all people with weapons and shit.
I didn't realize they had weapons.
Well, they when they all dropped in, they all had, like, the one guy had the AA-12... The full auto shotgun.
The shotgun was awesome.
Oh, it's in fucking The Division, but it supposedly bites donkey dick.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really dick. I haven't seen one yet.
I was going to say, I thought they actually didn't put that in.
No, they put it in this time. It was on this roll through. It was this one of the weapons that... Up. Yeah, this new fuck up. Because they promote it in the last rollout. The last Division fucking...
A third of the guns weren't there that they talked about being there.
No, it's just the one. They didn't even talk about it. They just showed it. And like, well, what's that? Is that going to be in it? And then it turned out not to be in it. But yeah, they all had, like, the one was the Yakuza guy had a gun and a sword.
Nice.
And then the I think there was the one dude. It was the one, Tobey Maguire's character. Not Tobey Maguire.
Rachel Madsen.
No, the dude from that 70s show.
Topher Grace.
Topher Grace. Thank you. He was in it. And I think he was just like a sociopath.
That's a weapon itself.
Yeah. So I don't know, like, if he had a weapon at one point in time and he killed him, but I don't remember. I haven't seen that movie in forever. But it was weird. It was like a clan war at the same time, because they ended up finding a predator.
Interesting.
Joe's walking around doing stuff.
Yeah.
Distracting. Yeah. So that's Predator, I guess. Just kind of does sidetrack from...
And I like turtles.
Talking with... Turtles!
Joe, did you have any more rants that you wanted to go on? Oh, wait, hang on. You know what? If we're going to talk about this for a moment...
We were talking about Idris Elba. You know, Idris Elba was in something else.
Star Trek.
Other than Star Trek and Thor.
Star Trek.
Nick won't let me rant.
That's him?
That's 20 seconds?
It's about... I got to the number!
Loud noises.
But yeah, that was Idris Elba. I didn't realize that. It said, like, the opening credits is Idris Elba.
I didn't realize
and
that.
And Anderson Paak. Or Anderson Paak.
Okay, here. For a few minutes before we finish the cast. Favorite television shows that you don't think got enough time or you want to see more of? Obviously for you, Deadwood.
Oh, I got a couple.
I know, we've got a few. I'm saying let's do a few.
Justified is another one.
Have you seen Hell on Wheels?
Negative.
Watch that. It's tits.
I'm gonna.
For being like an AMC show, it's pretty gritty, but it's more of like, because in the Wild West shows, they show things are, you know, like you watch...
Prostitutes.
That's in there. But you watch... oh, fuck. What was the fucking... Kirk Douglas and... Val Kilmer. God damn it. Why can't I think of it?
I'm not sure.
Fucking Wild West. The showdown of the OK Corral's in it. God damn it. I can't think of this movie. God damn you, IMDb. Help me.
All right, I'm an idiot. Moving on to
but
Joe
anyways,
for a minute.
But it's gritty. It's gritty and dirty. Because you always think of, like, you see these Wild West movies and everyone's clean. And they're, like, well kept. And, like, their clothes are, like, pressed and shit. This says fuck that. It's
Cowboys versus Aliens.
Yeah. Cowboys and Indians. It's dirty. It's gritty. It's not clean. It's not nice. It's not
friendly.
We're
not saying that the Indians are dirty.
No. Not at all.
Just sure as shit not a fucking clean time, though.
Yeah.
Yes.
We admitted.
But anyways.
Washing machines.
Hell on Wheels was canceled. So that's done. That I wish would keep going. Penny Dreadful.
That's canceled now?
Penny Dreadful was canceled their last season. They just ended their last season, so season 3 is over. I just got done watching season 2.
Nick just showed me, put his hands like boobies.
I was waiting for Joe. I was waiting for Joe to, for me, when I went, well, they didn't have washing machines, and I was waiting, I literally looked at Joe, and I was like, Joe's going to say it. Joe's going to say women. Joe's just going to say straight up women.
No, because I don't want to offend anyone that listens to this cast. Well, that's why you won't let me rant.
I'm not letting you rant about political shit.
Right.
That's why we're going to make another channel for you, exclusively.
I don't know if people can handle that.
I'll even join on for it, just to help you occasionally.
Me and Nick have extremely opposite views.
Yes, we do.
Of a lot of things.
Yes, we do.
And I'm doing my bestest.
You're succeeding. What else do you want to see still out there, Vickle? Or should we move to Joe for one?
Go to Joe, and I'll come. I'll
Joe, one of yours, please, sir.
I wish Franklin and Bash.
I loved Franklin and Bash.
That was a great show. And what was that? The Other Guys?
Oh my God,
the
other
TV
guys.
Show with
Dude,
the
you
stash.
Know, do you know Bradley Whitford's fucking Twitter profile is actually him with the dog?
From yeah.
The Other Guys. I didn't know that. I looked him up for something. Just like, I'll fucking look him up. I already follow him on Twitter, but I'll look him up real quick. And the first thing up was his Twitter page. And it was him and the dog. The nippy dog.
I mean, that show was fantastic.
It was the best fucking... It was the best cop show that had been out in decades.
It really was a good show. I mean...
What was the problem with it?
I don't know.
The network it was on.
Well, yeah.
They're quick cancelers.
I mean, if they were on, let's say, AMC... Even, I think... Well, they should have been like FX.
Yeah, I know. It really belonged in FX.
Have that right after Sons of Anarchy?
Yep. Fucking laugh your ass off after you had some serious
shit.
I'm
looking forward to the first nine.
First nine.
It is the prequel to the Sons of Anarchy.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
Huh.
Yes, and...
television show or movie?
Television show, and Brad Pitt.
Really?
Supposedly, from what I heard, has signed on
to
be in this TV show.
He's going
to
be in it, not just directing and producing?
It. No, he is going to be...
I love when fucking movie actors
He
do
is
that.
Going to be yeah. Jax Teller's padre.
Fuck, that would actually be perfect.
Oh, the character you never meet
yeah.
in the show.
The fucking you just get
nice.
The book from.
Yeah.
That'd be actually awesome.
Yeah.
I would love to see him in that role. That'd be cool.
Although, I would much rather see...
So they're going to bring back the original cast?
That was
no.
the thing.
So
no.
this is going to be pre-them?
This is the
this is the beginning of the first sons. Nine guys.
The first sons.
It's not just the sons, though.
But wasn't...
because...
well, I know, but
was it Ron Perlman's character, one of them?
Yeah.
Yes.
Ron Perlman's coming back? Ron Perlman's going to be in it.
How the fuck is he going to be in it? He looks old as shit. I love Ron Perlman, don't get me wrong.
Maybe it's not... maybe they're going to have all new castings for everyone, but they're just going
to... I mean, and not to mention Jack's mom. She's fucking... I mean, don't get me wrong. She ages extremely well, but Jesus fucking Christ.
R.I.P. She's still
noticeably older.
R.I.P. to Jack Schiller's wife.
That's true. But no, I mean, like, literally. I mean, she was in Married with
Children. Tara!
She's in Married with Children, for fuck's sake.
Yeah.
But she's... I honestly think she looks better now, too. She's ages really well and almost creepily like she doesn't age.
Yes.
Yeah. So what was yours? You wanted to see Justified. You wanted to see...
yeah.
Looking forward to the fucking... the first nine.
Yeah, and I think those
and
are
the
all
good,
my...
And the good guys.
Yeah, I think those are mine.
All right, let's see. One of mine I would love to see back. I mean, there's the quintessential obvious Firefly, but, you know, that's not happening. Oh, God.
Never seen it.
It's okay. So sorry. I'd love to see the Firefly back, but that's probably never going to happen. The other guys is honestly the one I was thinking of, to be quite honest. The other guys, I love that show. And they could still fuck it. They could pick it up right where they left off. They can pick it up a couple of years after.
All they need still is him a stash. And
Bradley
Whitford,
I think, still has the stash.
There's the show.
Wouldn't be surprised.
Just follow him around.
Colin Hanks.
Did you check out Rush yet?
No, I have not.
You need to watch that, because that was fucking tits.
Rush, the movie?
No, it was a show. It was the guy that plays...
the devil in fucking Lucifer.
And the new Lucifer Which, show.
That's a great
I haven't watched
show.
That show.
That's a great show. I enjoyed
plays,
the shit out of
He plays
the
devil
show.
In that, but in this, he's a... like a genius doctor, but he's got a drug problem.
Slight.
So he gets his father was head of the hospital. His father, you know, kicks him out of the hospital, whatever. And they're in L.A. So he decides he's just going to start his own firm. And he does cash under the table for it's all the shit you don't want to go to the doctor with or go to the hospital for.
Nice.
So good it's job, him. And like that. He's doing blow. He's smoking weed. He's fucking taking pills all day. Like he's getting like fucked up all day. And he's going, but he goes, like, there's a movie producer, and his, you know, he's, you know, 57, bald, fat guy, and his 22-year-old blonde girlfriend breaks his dick.
Oh.
So he's got to go, like, all right, you didn't break it, you just kind of, you know, pull the muscle here, you know, let me fix this, blah, 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 blah. All right, that's 50 grand. Like, charges them unbelievably. He lives in a hotel, like, in a fucking sweet-ass fucking hotel. And you get into like his like receptionist or his assistant that like takes care of all of his shit, like her backstory and stuff like that. She's got like an abusive. She used to work for another doctor, and he was they ended up dating, and he was like severely abusive. But then he gets like into his love life, which kind of kind of made it go a little sideways. But it was a lot more fun when it was more just him going on calls. But it got canceled. But then there was another show that was on.
USA.
On USA at the same time.
Royal Pains or something like
that. No, not Royal Pains. It was,
I thought it was
the adulterer show where the guy and his wife, like, the guy becomes a gigolo and she ends up cheating on her husband.
Huff.
Huh?
Huff?
No, it was,
Wasn't that Huff? It's got the fucking, Aaron Eckhart.
No.
Not Aaron Eckhart.
No.
The guy who played Punisher.
No. That's Aaron Eckhart.
That's a show, though. No. Aaron Eckhart didn't play Punisher.
No, not Aaron Eckhart. The other guy.
Yeah, Punisher guy.
Aaron, no.
I don't know his name.
Shit.
Punish, I'm looking it up right now. You don't have to worry about it.
Which, see. Aaron Eckhart and him did a movie together called Thursday, which is fantastic. If no one's seen
Thomas
it.
Jane.
Thomas Jane. If you get the chance to see the movie Thursday, it's very Pulp Fiction-ish.
Hung is the show.
Hung was, that was on Showtime or something. But this was on, it was on USA at the same time as Rush, and it was some, like, horrible, like, stupid white people problems where they're like stupid rich and she's unhappy with the marriage so she decides to cheat and at the same time he wants to cheat but he like does it with someone and gets paid for it so he becomes an escort and brings him into this whole like sex for money world type thing and I'm like this just looks like shit. I watched like 20 minutes of the episode and it was garbage. That kept going for a second season but of course Rush didn't even though it was funny as shit and awesome. There was a scene, this is my favorite scene in the whole thing. He keeps on going back to this baseball player's house who beats the shit out of his girlfriend.
Mm.
And, you know, checking on her, make sure she didn't have a concussion, blah, 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 fix her up, give her a couple stitches, whatever. So he gets a call, I think the end of the first or the second episode, gets a call to go back there. He goes back, he beat the fuck out of his girlfriend. And he's just getting pissed of having to come back to this dude's house.
Yeah.
So he comes back. I think the guy broke his hand beating her so hard.
Jesus Christ.
And that's why he had to come back and, like, help him out or whatever. So he's just furious, and he's, like, walking out the door. He's like, well, you know, Doc, at least I got you here to help me fix all this shit. And something just flips. He grabs a baseball bat off the wall and beats the piss out of this dude. Like, shatters his hand. Nice. I guess your career's over now. Like, to see how you explain that one. Because I wasn't here, and just, like, throws the bat on the floor.
Nice. Great. All right. I've got two more.
Okay.
I want to see Studio 60 on the Sunset Strip.
Say that in English.
Studio 60 on the Sunset Strip.
I don't remember that.
It was the third Aaron Sorkin television show. It was it started up around the same time that 30 Rock started up. It was basically a similar show, except it was...
Was that fucking...
It was Bradley Whitford, and it was fucking Matthew Perry.
Yes, that was good. I like that.
Was phenomenal. That was really good. That's easily one of my favorite shows of the last 10 years. And Jericho.
I never got into Jericho.
You never got into Jericho? Did you watch it? Or just not?
I caught a couple episodes because it was in syndication.
Mm-hmm.
And I caught a couple of them. The cast was good. I remember the cast was awesome.
Fuck yes.
The guy that plays Morgan on Walking Dead was in it.
Yes. He was one of the best parts. You have no idea what the fuck he is through the whole show.
Yeah, you think he's like some kind of like agent or something. Like, you have no idea what the fuck's going on through the whole show anyways. You're like, mm-hmm. there was a nuclear bomb or something.
There were a lot of nuclear bombs that
supposedly, but they don't know like if it was an attack, if it was a test.
It seemed
like they can't get communication outside. They don't know what's going on. They can't get outside of anything.
It seemed like it was an attack overall. Not like we're going to go and drop bombs, but like a terrorist attack.
Yeah.
Like they got like 30 fucking nukes. And set them all off, and the one.
But then they can't get communication anywhere, so they don't know what the fuck's going on.
Exactly.
They can't get outside of their area because it's all closed off.
They finally got fucking some cable back, and they literally the only thing that was on was still like what was from a fucking this television station when it went offline.
Yeah.
It was just showing this portion of highway that was decimated, and that's all that was on the television for like, and that was on like three fucking episodes of them just staring to see if anything else happened. It was so fucking good. The guy who played the main character of Jericho, not to mention Morgan.
The guy that was in Scream, wasn't the guy that from Scream, was in it?
Oh.
Fucking Zeke Ulrich?
Not a clue. I would never know his fucking name if my life depended on it, probably. But he was phenomenal. The guy who plays Morgan in fucking Walking Dead, always good. That literally was the only reason I started watching Walking Dead, full truth. Was because he was in the first episode. I was like, fuck yes, I'll watch a television show with him. He's in one episode in the fucking whole first couple seasons. I'm like, I'm very sad now. I've almost completely gotten
Skeet
out of Walking
Ulrich.
Dead. Skeet Ulrich, there it is. I've almost completely Skeet gotten Ulrich. Out of Walking Dead.
Really?
Yeah.
God, it's so good. The guy that they casted.
It's so fucking slow, though.
Well, because it got super slow.
And it killed me. I literally stopped watching after, I think, season 3 or 4. I've not gotten back to it.
It's just one of those shows that's
so well casted.
I can't
wait for the new season to come out. Seeing, what's his name, Negan?
The guy they cast is Negan. Oh, shit, what the fuck is his name? God damn, I'm so unprepared.
I can't think what his name is, but
well, we weren't originally talking about this. It's okay, man.
Well, he was the dad from Supernatural.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
he's awesome. I like him.
He's playing Negan, and Jesus H. Criminy, is he awesome?
I love him. He's
like
phenomenal.
He comes out of this trailer, and just starts talking shit. And it was funny because like he has the foulest mouth in the comic.
Nice.
And
it made it TV appropriate.
It's worse than you.
Yes.
And
the first thing I actually ever saw him in, overall, other than Supernatural, was Grey's Anatomy.
Yeah, he was in Grey's Anatomy. That's why Susan's like, oh my god, he's in Grey's Anatomy.
I know him because of The Good Wife, which was a pretty good show.
Is it done?
Yes, it's over.
How'd it go? Is Mr. Big still there?
Yes.
Michael J. Fox, was he a regular after
that? Are you talking Spin City?
He was. He was kind of a regular on there.
Well, no, you remember because he bought into the other firm.
Yeah, and the other firm comes
Jeffrey
back
Dean Morgan.
Yes! That's awesome.
See, after because, occasionally, I would come over here and we'd all watch The Good Wife and shit. And something else that was on around that time, too. I think it might be Good Guys, actually, or Franklin and Bash. We'd literally get together and watch that shit. I think I more or less just kind of stopped watching The Good Wife.
Yeah.
Julianne Margulies.
Yeah. So.
You know, that was a pretty good show. I can't...
You know what really, I think, got me out of the show? Was another show that I would love to see come back. One of the stars of that, actually, was... What, killed in the episode? The fucking head of the other firm was killed at the courthouse?
No, that was a partner. Her partner, yeah.
Yeah. When he died, I pretty much just lost interest in the show overall. Because he was on...
But he kept coming back.
He was on a show that I would love to see come back, which was CSC. Or Sports Night. Sports Night.
Oh, okay.
That was a great fucking show.
That was good. Can we talk about some because we were kind of leaving out the whole fact of San Diego Comic-Con was...
It happened.
The crap that was premiered.
Go with it.
Crap. That does not sound...
All right, so there was a new trailer for Suicide Squad, which I'm actually really excited to see.
So excited.
It looks really good.
Yeah.
Which I think... Doesn't that come out Friday?
I think it might.
Come plus Friday.
Yes.
And then
this is
which I don't have to work on Friday.
Let's go see it.
And then there was a trailer for Justice League, which they have like shot pieces of and put together just so they had something to like flash.
Show at Comic-Con.
Then they had to throw, you know, the flash had to be like extremely humorous.
So. See, I don't.
So
see.
Did so was fucking like Ben Affleck had to like be joking on the whole. Have you watched the trailer?
No. Actually, you know what? Yeah. I did see it, actually. I saw most of the trailers that came out.
Yeah. But it was kind of like, he was funny.
It was forgettable.
So they're trying to, like, all this funny shit in it. Because they're seeing how you can't be completely...
Dark
in a movie because of Batman and Superman. Which I still haven't watched yet. I was supposed to watch it yesterday
really
with the boys.
You don't really need to.
Yeah. I told you, I was walking through Walmart, and I'm like, oh, I should buy this. No, it's Batman and Superman. Never mind. I was even looking for one with just, I was like, even like the DVD by itself is $20. The combo is $32.
I think I did like Batman vs. Superman.
You did?
I did.
How much of it? Because you're about to start giving a few things here, so keep on going.
What's that?
You're like, the first hour or so was boring.
No, I didn't say that.
I'm saying it right now.
Yeah. It was a very slow-paced movie, and I think they could have done so much better than they did.
I'm still not a fan of this Superman, to be quite honest. Henry Cavill looks like a great Superman.
Personality of a fucking wet sock.
I know. That's my fucking problem with him. He overall looks like you think Superman should fucking look.
Yeah, he looks like, but he's just...
But he just does not have the personality for it.
No,
I don't know if that's bad writing.
Smile or...
I don't know if that's bad writing or if it's him.
I think
it's
him.
Look at like all the old, like he was.
No, he was in that fucking that other movie that just came out and it got rave reviews. The fucking one where it was like the he's like an agent for something.
Oh, Agents of Uncle.
Yeah, and it got
the
good reviews.
The man from Uncle.
Yeah,
it was good.
Yeah.
I watched it. It was good. It was
and
funny.
Was he good in it?
He was good in it.
It's
really
gotta be the fucking writing.
But it's the writing.
It's gotta be the
it's
writing.
So who's it? Who the fuck? Not Zack Snyder, is it?
I think it might be Zack Snyder.
Did he do the Batman series?
No, he did the Superman.
No, Christopher Nolan did the Batman.
And
Zack Snyder...
Christopher Nolan's shit is solid as fucking gold.
Fucking tits.
Yeah.
I can't say any of those movies were disappointing other than some of the last one, kind
of. Some of the last one, but the thing I fucking realized recently was, you know why some of the fight scenes in fucking the third one kind of looked like shit compared to two? Heath Ledger told Christian Bale to hit him as hard as he fucking could.
Yeah.
He was like, pretend you're Batman, and I'm the fucking Joker.
Hit me!
And swing, bitch.
Heath Ledger.
Heath Ledger fucking was like, bring it. Seriously. He told the guy to fucking bring it. And
don't get me wrong, Tom Hardy is a fucking amazing actor.
Yeah.
But you could tell they're holding punches.
Well, plus they had that prosthesis on his face.
Yeah, I know.
Which
the clamshell.
I didn't like the fucking the way they did Bane. He was not the character from the comic whatsoever.
Well, I liked.
I enjoyed it. While I
no,
did
but there
like
was
his
no
portrayal.
Like fucking like super like here no venom serum or anything
I know.
Like that.
Oh no, it wasn't. I know it was. They fucking took as far a step away from Tim Burton as they could on that one.
Yeah. Well, no, even from the fucking comic.
Or oh, something. I know. But still, they were fucking. They're like, we saw how that one went on the other one. No, we're good.
Well, they could have had him like juice up at one point, like the first fight scene or
something.
That'd be fine.
And they kind of tried to say that's what the fucking mask was.
Yeah.
No, that
but
was
they didn't do a very
supporting
clear
his
job
face
because
his face was all fucked up.
Do you hear I enjoyed it.
They're recasting. They're trying to do a new Interview with the Vampire.
Oh, fuck.
They wanted to redo it.
Who?
Why?
Jared Leto playing Lestat.
Dude, don't get me wrong. I like Jared Leto. I think he's a
they
good
want
actor.
To go through. They want to do the four books. They want to do
really?
Interview.
Interview with the Vampire. Fucking Lestat, Memnock the Devil.
Queen of Them and Memnock the Devil.
Jesus Christ.
Which Memnock the Devil was one of my
favorite
fucking
books
out of that whole set.
And it's
oh, yeah.
about to be ruined.
Yep.
And I like Jared Leto. I think he's a great actor.
I think he's a great actor.
But I think if they do it with...
I think he's going to be actually drinking blood at some point during the next
probably.
Few years.
But the thing is,
Jared
with him,
extremely method.
If they do Lestat, he can actually sing instead of having some dude fucking...
That would
like,
be nice.
Having Jonathan Davis do the fucking voiceover voice. Who the fuck wants Jonathan... Since when did Jonathan Davis have a good singing voice?
Never.
Never?
Never. He would be actually awesome with that. But at the same point, I'm pretty sure he'd fucking start drinking blood.
He would.
Which terrifies me.
But the only thing I would have, the only problem I would have is they would have to recast Brad Pitt as Luis.
I'd be fine with that.
Because he was Luis. Like, after
perfect.
Reading those books and then watching the movie.
He was perfect.
Yeah. He was that character.
Yeah.
So there's no way they could find someone else to play that.
No, what they would do is try and
they would
fuck it up.
It'd be like, Andrew Garfield as Luis. Like, oh, shut the fuck up. Which his new movie looks
terrible.
You know, did you see like who's doing it?
No, I didn't see who's doing it.
It's from the director of Braveheart and Passion of the Christ, but they never say his name.
Oh no,
it's Mel Gibson.
Wait, which movie?
Braveheart and Passion of the Christ.
Was it
Andrew Garfield?
Hacksaw Ridge.
Yeah,
the Andrew Garfield's new war movie where he just refuses to use a weapon.
Yeah,
but he ends up saving all these men off the battlefield. But it's and they never say like does he? I guess he's still got the stink.
Oh,
no one wants to say Mel Gibson.
Yeah.
But he's going to throw a shit ton of money towards this movie.
But you know what? We'll say it. Mel fucking Gibson.
Mel Gibson.
I'm not going to lie. I used to love Mel Gibson. He was a great actor at times.
I still think he's a great actor.
I think he's gone a little nuts.
He's gone a little crazy.
That's got nothing to do with being a great actor.
I don't know. What was the movie with him as the Boston cop? And his daughter gets killed.
I don't know.
No, that's John Travolta.
No. No, his daughter gets killed.
I think it is John
Travolta. And... It turned out it was because she was an activist for, like, an environmental activist, and she found out, like, this one company was, like, dumping shit into the river, and so she was trying to, like, find this information, and it was, like, she gets shotgunned at her front door. And then, of course, they take him off the case because they don't want him having anything to do with it.
I do not know the movie you're talking about, sir.
No. It was good. It was good. I mean, it was Mel Gibson, like, showing his age. He was playing a character his own age. But if you go back to, like, Lethal Weapon and shit, oh my god.
Fuck, yes, Lethal Weapon.
I was doing that the other day. We were having a Nerf gun fight in the middle of the playroom. And I was doing that. I was like, I gotta do the Mel Gibson roll. And I'm rolling around the floor. Psh, 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 shooting the boys in the Nerf gun.
That's awesome.
That's great. I have to pee really bad.
There's an outside. I was going to see if Joe had anything more to say because he started doing it. Right around the garage.
Right around the back of the garage?
Over by the shed.
Is there neighbors back there?
Yes.
Yeah, is there wasps or...
Just be cautious because there's also...
Chairs.
Chairs. Just past the chairs.
Yeah.
By the wood pile.
No, there's a shed in the way.
There's a shed there now?
There's a shed there now.
Pee by the shed.
Pee by the shed.
You were about to say something now. You literally started saying something and then he was like, I need to pee.
I literally don't know.
Oh, right.
I think. Cops are awesome.
All right.
What about the ones that are just fucking hauling ass to haul ass? I've watched it where a cop blows the light and literally just slows down after it and isn't going anywhere, but just goes to a parking lot and just parks. I mean, I've seen that. You've probably seen that shit.
They should get a ticket.
They should, but who's going to give them a fucking ticket?
If they get reported, the chief. Everything's got cameras now because of the stupid motherfuckers that want to fight the cops that do their job, and they end up, someone gets shot because they're a shithead. And now, if we don't have cameras on our bodies and in our cars and on the tasers...
There's a camera on the taser?
Yeah. Not all, but some police departments have cameras in the tasers. They cannot... Their word is no longer good unless there's video.
So some assholes the other day hopped a fence in Toledo. At the Toledo Zoo, broke into the Toledo Zoo to try to catch Pokemon.
Yeah.
Hopped the fence to a tiger enclosure.
That's stupid, mm-hmm. people.
But see, again, it's... These stupid people are giving everyone a bad name.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, just like a few bad cops give cops a bad name. You know? Mm. A few Black Lives Matter protesters give all of them a bad name. You know, it takes one bad apple to ruin a bunch.
Absolutely.
And they can suck a dick. A bad cop should be arrested and thrown in jail.
Absolutely.
Just like every other shithead.
Well, God, yeah.
They caught a guy in Mansfield who had a warrant out for his arrest. And the only reason he was out was outside because he was hunting out a Pokemon.
See, it's helpful.
No, but again, you have to look at what we call the totality of the circumstances. That's something we have to use with every case that we work. And, you know, it's just as simple as we don't know the facts, and that's where you run into the biggest problem. So,
but no, the firefighter was more talking about how you could use this thing as kind of a nice soft interaction tool, like that cop that had the basketball game thing that then Shaq fucking went and did with him too.
Listen, the firemen should stick to picking shingles and saving cats. Okay?
Mm.
Leave the police work to the police.
I mean, they have to have someone to look up to. I know the police need someone to look up to. It's okay.
We look up to God. Other than that, we look down at firemen.
You don't have to call firefighters gods, Joe.
That's because they're not.
They're good men.
No, see, the firemen don't know. They don't know. Just like we don't know fighting fires. You know, we're not paramedics. We're not firemen. We don't do that shit. You know why?
Why?
Because we're not trained.
Mm-hmm.
Just like they're not trained in law enforcement.
Oh, yeah.
Anyone who's not trained in law enforcement needs to shut the fuck up about what we do. Unless you walk a mile in our shoes.
You've walked a mile in their shoes. That's why you're part of the conversation, motherfucker.
I know. What I'm saying is, unless you walk a mile in their shoes, you should not be able to criticize us and tell us how to do our job. And now, I'm not saying that about you or your friend. That's a fireman.
Mm-hmm.
But people have a great idea of what it's like to be a cop. They have an idea of, you know, this, that, and the other thing, and, oh, I'd do this, oh, I'd fucking arrest this guy for doing this, tickets and that.
Yeah.
But it's fucking just not the way it works.
Oh, God, no.
I'm looking to see a PokeVision back up.
I'll end my rant there.
It's not a bad place.
Because I have a lot more to say. I'm just trying to be good for you.
I appreciate that. Let's see. I don't think there's anything else we need to talk about tonight.
No, I think I'm good.
Other than the fact that I
peed behind a garage.
Other than the fact that I was guest casting over at Invasion of the Podcast recently.
Yeah.
Which will be a nice link to that episode as well.
And I've never been invited.
I was the first of the entire group to be invited.
Doesn't matter. This is my first podcast.
Yeah.
In my garage.
See, there you go. Well, not only is it your first podcast, we came to you, sir.
Fucking right.
How often that happens?
Pretty often.
Not often.
We don't go to anyone else's garage to fucking record podcasts.
Well, where else can you drink booze and...
really horrible moonshine. I got a little glow going on just from that shot, so I'm not going to play. I just taste bad, but...
But it was fucking wicked, wasn't it?
Tastes like shit, but yeah, I'm sweaty. I'm sweaty, kind of, you know? It is kind of warm in here. What did the temperature say before? It was like, it's still 80 degrees.
Yeah. I don't have the side door open.
How warm is it outside compared to in the scratch? It's only 72 outside.
Yeah. Well, if that door was
66
open. If that outside, door was open, it's just cooler here.
Jesus Christ.
And then all of a sudden, there's just going to be Nick talking, like, and that's it for Geek Eclectic. It's like, wow, what happened to everyone else?
Wow. So, on that note, we should probably say goodnight, and everyone have a fantastic evening.
Everyone be safe.
And be safe and stuff.
And be nice to the cops.
We bid you adieu.
Absolutely. That's still parting. It's cut it. Oh, God, that's still parting 12 seconds.
There's no way that was 12 seconds.
No, the first portion was.
Oh. You could have just got him a lawsuit.
Who knows? We'll find out. This has been Geek Eclectic. I'm Nick.
I am the Vickle.
I'm Hefty Bison.
Oh, and we can be found on...
There we go. Thank you for bringing that next part on. Let's see. There's geekecpodcast@gmail.com if you want to email us. You can find us on Facebook, obviously, and Twitter at The Geek Eclectic.
I think you should give also PS4 YouTube. Handles.
Okay. Oh, for that's also.
And then I can be found on PSN as The Vickle. Mm-hmm.
The underscore
Vickle. On Twitter and YouTube and Instagram at Obi-Wan is Dead.
Which is a horrible name, by the way.
What? Great. And someone took it on PlayStation, or I'd beat Obi-Wan is Dead on PlayStation.
I am Joe, and I am Hefty Bison on the PlayStation Network, and I don't do the twatter, or I don't do Twitter, and I don't do Snapchats or Instagrams or...
Snapchat.
Snapchat. But if you need me...
Children that I fucking deal with all day.
You can email me at joetolero@gmail.com.
That's...
That's my name.
I am obviously Nick. You can find me on the PlayStation Network at Once in Future Geek. Or Greek, I'm sorry. Once in Future Greek.
You suck.
Cut that. We'll do that again. It's fine. let's see. I'm literally... the sad part is I don't know my own Twitter handle at the time.
So do I even have Twitter?
Geek Eclectic. I think, is it just Geek Eclectic? Yeah. Because on YouTube, it's The Geek Eclectic for us.
Well, listen, if any of these folks
The Geek
watching,
Eclectic as well.
If any of these folks watching and listening, because they're going to do both,
hopefully,
probably.
Maybe.
If they need to get a hold of me, let you know, and I will get a twatter and snap face and, you know, Google Snapchat face shit.
He'll restart his MySpace page.
Oh, fuck that.
Not to mention, you can also reach me at geekeclectic.nick@gmail.com. Thanks again for listening and watching, and hopefully both even. But we bid you adieu.
Deuces!